So today, we have a few guests with us. I'm Clara, and this is...
Chani.
And Stein.
Clara.
Jeffy.
So today's topic is about ideal workplace for millennials. So, I mean, I think all of us here, we are counted. So what do you ask to you guys?
Yeah.
I'm not like very sad, are you? So what do you guys feel is like the ideal workplace? Yeah, so I think we break down to a few areas, like be it like do you feel culture, do you feel people around you, and maybe what do you expect to see in your workplace? So like what do you feel like?
What's the dream
place? Yeah. What's your dream workplace?
That's a very good question.
You do.
For myself, what I'm expecting for more towards the environment.
So you like young, like work like together with a lot of insights, work like together with a lot of insights.
No, before I share my opinion, right? Okay, actually I read an article recently. Okay, it's about workspace environment. Yeah. So they actually came up with a statistic that, you know, like 40% of the workspace in Singapore is like open. Okay, what I mean by open is that, you know, it's not desk bound, but your workplace is constantly shifting between open desks. Yeah. So I mean, for me, I would prefer that kind of environment, which means that it's very open. It's not like cubicle by cubicle. So at least we can interact, and you know, where discussions can be, I would say, be more spontaneous and instantaneous. Okay, and like, you know, it can spark out new ideas and new working practices and stuff. Yeah, that is something that I would like to try out, but to see if it suits me. In that case, I would like to put it in the camera. It's a shift away from what we usually associate with the traditional office environment, which is I think it's more comfortable and more, I'll use the word chill.
What about you?
For me, like, what's important
is
to have a good work environment. So when I found out that BGC is like moving into e-contract signing, so I was like super glad because we are saving thousands of papers. We may not realize the numbers now, but then in the long term, like if we have some sort of like measurement, we are actually doing quite a big impact, because I don't know, God knows how many contracts we generate per week if we are using paper, and that's quite a lot. So I think that's quite a big move from BGC group. Like the process was quite tedious to adjust. Yeah, but I think if, you know, like 1 or 2 years down the road, I think it's quite a substantial impact. So I'm glad like I'm in a place where I can witness firsthand how environmental impact is important to me.
Some people, they're okay with working like MNCs, like in banks or whatsoever, where their structures are more, the workplace is more rigid in terms of like the environment, the people you're working with, because that's how it's been structured. But would it be like a considering factor as to whether you choose or not?
I think one factor, why I always ask an interview, my team is all that. So, what is the hierarchy like? Approval process, is it super long? Is it flat? So, from there, I'll get a sense of, you know, of how open the culture will be, in terms of, like, you know, power distance between colleagues, your superiors, and all that. That's one factor I look
for. I would say for me, be it now and my previous workplace, right? Both workplaces that I've been to, we have a more open, it's like a more flat structure whereby you have direct access to your boss. So you are able to provide feedback to your management as and when. I think because I'm the kind that I cannot take too rigid structure. I cannot take like too long of a process. Like to me, I see it as like not efficient. So it's not a place that I would want. I wouldn't be able to see myself working in such areas.
I would say I don't have any preference over instant gratification or even delayed gratification. Both is great. As long as I get the job done, it's fine. Yeah. So even if I have to wait for a while before I get approval, it's fine. As long as that's the company's way of doing things. In totality, apart from just my people, but I mean, if they're energetic, it's a bonus because I don't have to drag myself to work and then it's so quiet. And, apart from that, I think what I want is there are two other things that I'm looking for. Firstly, is a purpose. The reason why I took this up is because I had the intention to help people with something. That is why I wanted to give it a try to see if they're not. Well, after all, it's their livelihood. So if I can help them, then why not? Then the other one would be actually to learn. Yeah, I feel that the management, the leadership is important because it will give me a role model to model myself after if it is someone who is suitable.
Are there any like huge no-nos in terms of workplace?
You all got answers, you might go first. Huge no-nos. I don't have any huge no-nos that perhaps a company has that I might not take. But it's more towards perhaps an industry that they are dealing with. Then there will be certain kind of things that I will not pick up unless I'm desperate. So those will be the great things for me. No? But apart from that, how open?
To different work environments.
Because I'm still young and I want to learn.
Oh! Okay, I'll put a caption here that you are 24 from here, right?
You put a 24 on
okay. So that people always know that. Your whole...
Wow! I am adaptable, but I do have my preferences. But if I don't get my preferences,
Yeah, fine.
Because for me, it's just to get the experience, get the money. No, I'll say the time. You know, it's more about being self-sufficient and time. Yeah.
For me, like one big annoying of is working too much. So, I think, you know, like, I'm taking a small step to actually to learn to work efficiently. I don't mind working overtime, but then that's based on the reason that I have to, unless it's really, really urgent that I have to serve someone important, then I would be ready to stay with the time.
Yeah, I think it's a very big point that you got. Because like, when Sarah asked the question, I really don't know what's my big normal. But now that she mentioned it, right, I think it's baseline culture. Yeah, I don't agree with baseline culture. Let's say your boss have an immediate and you get I cannot understand that. For me, right, if my boss stays and expects me to stay, and I have no work to be done, I'll be like, just fine.
It's easy for me to say, but don't succumb to peer pressure just because this person is working, let's say, in JP Morgan Goldman Sachs. Yeah. Don't overpromise yourself in the kind of environment that your peers paid for you, because it may not all be a fairy tale. So always paint a realistic picture for yourself.
Yourself comes first instead of others. Okay, I actually second what she has shared. And the reason is because I think after graduation, you will have a fair share of people who don't know what they want to do. But they probably have a list of things that they don't want to do. So if you know what you want to do, then of course try not to get into that. But for those things that you are willing to try out, you should, I feel like at the very least, you should consider just jumping in first, alright, and see if the environment suits you or not. Because if you are looking for something that, you know, you are so hard up finding what you exactly want, right, it might be very difficult for you to find the exact same environment. But rather, instead of the company adapting to you, perhaps you should look into adapting to the company, just like how the world doesn't revolve around you. From there on, you can actually work towards, you know, like what my colleague has shared also, shortlisting the one that you really like to work for, and perhaps something that you can find a purpose in doing, so that at least you don't drag yourself to work every day. And also, I forgot what I said for the last part already, so that's about all that. Yeah,
great. Alright guys, so that's all for today. Remember to leave in the comment section below what you think your ideal workplace environment is. Don't forget to like and share this video, and remember to keep the subscribe button at the bottom. Alright? See you again. Bye!
I scared eh, once I appeal then, wow, suddenly the YouTube channel.
Eh, bro.
Oh, let me show that happens.
Yeah, I mean like this one.